Mr. Death Breath. 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 Hey guys, welcome back to my channel! I'm Mr. Death Breath, where I do spoiler-free film reviews! Hey guys, before we begin, please turn on post notifications, please subscribe, please share, please do all those amazing things. And guess what? I'm on Spotify. Search Mr. Death Breath. Follow me on Spotify for audio versions of these videos. Let's get into it. Hey guys, so let's talk about Candyman, directed by Nia DaCosta, co-written by Nia DaCosta, also written by Jordan Peele. Synopsis: an artist goes down a dangerous path when he starts following up on the myth of Candyman. Okay, so let's get to the good. The directing by Nia DaCosta. She has great tension throughout the film, beautiful cinematography. She balances tension and injects humor in a way that doesn't feel forced or distracting. It's actually wonderful. And when the moments of humor come, you're like, oh, that's so great. You don't even notice. It's absolutely fantastic. The standouts of the cast: Yua Manteen Abdul is amazing. He plays Anthony, he's the lead, he's likable and relatable. He does a phenomenal job. Tiana Paris as Brianna is amazing. She does a great job as well. She carries the film and works really well with Yua. And last, Nathan Stewart. He plays Brianna's brother. He's hysterical. He's funny. Every time he's in a scene, he's hilarious. He's so funny that it's hard to believe that this was even a script that he read lines for. It felt like he was just saying what he thought, and it's hysterical. One thing I also love about Candyman 2021 is it doesn't hold back on violence. When there's violence, it's ample. It's plenty. It's grotesque. It's scary. It's wonderful. Also, another thing that Nia DaCosta does is the subtlety in every scene. Trust me when I tell you, pay attention to the backgrounds of everything you see in the scene, because it's gonna matter and it's gonna have impact. And it's fantastic how it's done. There's things you miss, and things are probably missed. I also love that Candyman 2021 acknowledges Candyman, the first Candyman with Tony Todd. It's very much a direct sequel. One scene that really stuck with me and I couldn't shake specifically is, it's very much one of those, you may miss it because the scene's so beautiful, but what it is the camera is pulling out, basically panning out, or not panning, but pulling out, and it's doing a big, long, wide shot, this beautiful cinematic shot of a skyscraper. It is the scariest scene I've ever witnessed. I highly recommend that you pay attention to this scene. Pay attention to the windows. That's all I'll say. It just gave me the chills. It put me in a state of uncomfort that I was never able to recover from despite my best efforts. And it's not only a beautifully shot scene, but absolutely terrifying. And yes, the most frightening scene I've seen in a horror film is in Candyman 2021. Another thing that I love about Candyman 2021 is it interweaves Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Black lives have always mattered, and black lives will always continue to matter. Another wonderful thing about Candyman 2021 is the original score, that do-do-do-do-do-do, that beautiful piano melody, is prominent throughout this whole entire film. Okay, so let's get into the bad. There is no bad. Okay, so let's give this a rating, as we usually do. What is Candyman 2021? Candyman 2021 is an A+. Absolutely fantastic. The cast is phenomenal. The directing is phenomenal. The script is phenomenal. The story is phenomenal. There's nothing bad about this film. I'm willing to bet that Candyman is going to be number one for best film of the year. And the biggest problem is I wish I could own it, and I can't, so it really drives me nuts. So I highly recommend you guys go see Candyman 2021. It'll be in theaters on Thursday if you catch an early screening, around like 7 o'clock usually, and Friday, August 27th. Guys, thank you for your support, and as always, I will see you soon.